So now let's start with questions on average. So we have already seen some introduction to average. So that was easy. So let's see some questions. Not very tricky. Questions are not very tricky. Okay. So now let's see this. So before that, if you have any doubt, you can mail me. This is my mail ID, bosudeshna135@gmail.com. Okay. And if you love watching my videos, please do subscribe to my channel. Okay. So now this will I will add this in general aptitude playlist. You can easily find them. Okay. Now let's see first example. Find the average of 40 natural numbers. So 40 natural numbers we can find out like this. So first n into n plus 1 by 2. So this is our summation of 40 natural numbers. So this is summation of n natural numbers. Okay, this is a very important formula. Please write it down. So this is, so now for that here we have 40. So 40 into 41 divided by 2. So this is 220. So 20 into 41 is our summation. So now we have to just find out the average of 40 natural numbers. Okay, so this is 20 into 41 divided by 40. So the whatever the answer is, I'm telling you here the answer is 20.5. okay, so 20.5 is answer. This is the answer here. I hope you have understood this natural number. This is very easy. We have already seen this while we are doing algorithms and all. So this is very important. N into n plus 1 by 2, then divide by 40, because you have to find the average. This was summation, this is average. Okay. So now let's see this example. The average of cricket team with 11 players. Okay, so if 11 players would not have been given, I would have not answered, because most of the people know, everyone knows how many players are there in cricket, because I don't watch. One of my friend asked me and I was like blank one day, so this reminded me of that. So anyways, the average weight of cricket team with 11 players is 60 kgs. Okay, so there is average of 11 players. Let's say there are A10 plus A11. Their average weight is given as 60 kilos. Okay, so if the average weight increases by 0.5 kg when a player leaves the team. So let's say our player leaves the team and the average weight is increased by 0.5 kg. So they are asking what is the weight of the player who just left. Okay, so we have to find out that, let's say 11th player, he just left. So let's say we know this. So we can write it down as A1 plus A2 A10. If we take this as a bracket, let's say divide by 10 and into 10, it will give you same thing, by 11 plus 11 by 11. Okay, so this is 60. Total is average is 60. So now this part, this is this thing is average of 10 members. So if that 1% left, this person left, so the average of 10 players will be increased by 0.5. so total was 60. If it is increased, so it is now 60.5. the number will be increased by 0.5. so this is, and that 11th player with that who has left is A11, and this is already divided by 11, so this is 60. So now this is coming as 10 into 60.5 plus A11, 60 into 11. So now A11 is coming as 60 into 11 minus 10 into 60.5. So the answer here is 55. Okay, so the answer here is 55. The weight of that player who left is 55 kilos. Okay. So I hope you have understood this. So this is not a very tough question, so please practice more. So now this question, let's see this question, example 3. So the average age of 12 persons in a committee is increased by 1 year when the two men aged 35 and 43 are replaced by two women. Find the average age of two women. So the average age of 12 person, let's say A1, A2, A10 and A11 and A12 are replaced this age. This is firstly we are doing at the addition of all the age of men. So first list, men are 35 and 43. This divide by 12, let's say the average is X here. So you can see now here A1, this part is 78. Okay, so A1, A2 ... A10 plus 78 divide by 12 is equals to X here. So now just cross multiplying, we can get A1 plus A2 ... A10 plus 78 is 12x, or you can take 78 here minus 78 here. Okay, so this is the summation of A1 to A10. So now we can have this is our addition of A1 to A10. So now these two men will be replaced by these another women. So we have to find the average of two women who are replacing these two men. So now here let's say A1, A2 ... A10. So now let's say the women added are A11. So now here let me see, my video got stopped, sorry for that. So now here this is our new average. So A1 till A10 is same, the two men, this men are replaced with two women, divide by 12. So now here if you see this, the average is increased by 1 year. So previously average was X, now average is increased by 1. So now if we put A1 till A10 as this, 12x minus 78, then A11 plus A22 divide by 12x plus 1. Don't get scared, because we are getting two variables in a linear equation, so it doesn't matter, we are just one equation and two variables, but we will cancel it out. Okay, 12x minus 78 plus A11 plus A12, 12x plus 12. So you can see 12x is cancelled out. So A11 plus A12 is coming down to as, I'll tell you, 90. So it is coming down to as 90. And here it is asking the average age of two women. So average of two is just divide by two women is 90 divided by 2, that is 45. Okay, so here answer is 45 years. It was an easy question, just have to take something X and everything, so it is an easy question. Let's move on to next question. So now let's see this question. If the average of five consecutive even numbers is 44, find the highest number. So here I have written a note here. Whenever there is a series of numbers which are in arithmetic progression, okay, and if you try to find out the average of it, is always going to be the middle value. So average of the whole thing will be the middle value. So here we are asking, here it is asked as consecutive even numbers. So even numbers, let's say first is A, then next will be A plus 2, then it will be A plus 4, 1, 2, 3, A plus 6, next will be A plus 8. So now we have, because of this note, we can see the average of all this is exactly the middle value. Okay, so middle number. So here our middle number is A plus 4 and our average is given as 44. So A is coming as 40. And it is asked the highest number. So highest number is this, A plus 8. So A plus 8, A means 40 plus 8 is 48. Okay. So 48 is our answer. Okay. So whenever given numbers are like this, you can just find out the middle one is the average value. Okay. So let's see next question. So now let's see this question. Sorry. The average of five consecutive odd number. So here previously it was 5 consecutive even numbers, now it is 5 consecutively odd numbers, so it is 59. Okay, so what will be that sum of next set of 5 consecutive odd numbers? So let's see, the first is a, then it will be a plus 2. See, you can take a plus 1 also if you are just saying that, if you have thinking like a is also odd number, b. See, we are just taking some example, like we are taking an example variable. Okay, so it can be say different also. A plus 2, a plus 4, a plus 6, a plus 8. So you can take it like a plus 1, then a plus 3, like this. Okay, you can go on. So here this is 8. Okay, the average is 59. So average is the middle one, so this is actually 59. So now next is 61. This is 61, this is 63, this is 57, this is 55. Okay, so like this, this is our even, we can say this is because this is our average. So next is be plus 2 plus 2, or it will be minus 2 minus 2. But since it is asking what will be the sum of next set of 5 consecutive odd numbers, so it can be like this: 8 plus 9 10, a plus 12, a plus 14, 1 2 3, a plus 16, a plus 18. So like this, 63, this is 65, this is 67, this is 69, this is 71, this is 73. So they are asking the summation of all this. So summation of this 5 elements will be this 345. Okay, so the summation of all this next set of 5 odd consecutive numbers will be this, and the total will be 345. I hope this is understood. This is very easy. Okay, so now let's see this question. Average temperature for a week is noted as 27. Okay, so the temperature of average of a week is 27, so total of 7 days is 27. But later it was realized that one of the day's temperature reading was taken as 30 instead of 23. So what is the correct average of that week? So this is actually wrong average, they're asking the correct average. Okay, so in place of 30 we have to use 23. It is given. So let's say a1, a2 dot 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 a6 plus, wrongly it was written as 30 divided by 7, so wrong average was 27. Okay, so now a1, a2 dot 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 a6 is equals to 27 into 7 minus 30. Okay, so now here it is our, don't write like this, maybe look at the average. So summation of all these 6 days is this. Okay, so now we have to find out what is the correct one. So correct one is this will be there. Okay, so a1 to a6 will be there. So in place of 30 we will be using 23. Okay, so in place of 30 we will be using 23, and its average is 7. So you have to find out this, let's say x. Okay, so this is our x. So here you can find it out like this. This part we already know. This we can put this value 27 into 7 minus 30 plus 23 by 7. So you can anything it is, it will come down to as our correct average. So correct average is, so if we do this, so it will come down to as 26. Okay, so the correct average is 26. So I hope you have understood this. So we have seen a formula. So formula remembering is a tough thing, but since I have already said this formula in an introduction video of average, so let's put the formula here. Okay, so the new average is equals to old average plus new value minus old value by number of observations. So this old average is 27, right? Then new value is 30, old value is 23, and number of observations is 7 days. So you can, if you calculate it out, so it will give you the same answer. Okay, so I hope you have you can use this formula also if you can remember. If you cannot, you can just do the process I did. So whatever way you choose, you will get the answer correctly. Okay, So let's see this. This is an interesting question. So this kind of questions are, I think I, when I was in was giving this placement TCS, I did, and some kind of average question came. I don't remember exactly, but I think this kind of, it first of all, it was way back, and papers are submitted. I don't remember exactly, but this I think this kind of question was asked. Okay, so let me see. Let's do this question. Okay, so let me read it out. You can also pause the video and you can do the question by yourself. Okay, just then you can check the answer. You can have better solution. You can tell me. So the average of 25 results is 18. So the average of 25 numbers is 18. Then the average of first 12 of them is 14. The first 12 is 14 and the last 12 is 17. Find the 13th result. 13th number you have to find. So 12 plus 12 14 24 and the 13th will be 25. So total 13th 10th result, we can say that sum of 25 numbers minus sum of this first 12 and last 12. So sum of this 12 first 12 and sum of last 12. Okay, so like this. So sum of 25 numbers is 25 of 825 into this 18 is given 18. Okay, so minus sum of first 12. So first 12 is given as first 12, the sum is 14. 12 into 14 and the next is last 12 is 17. 12 into 17. Okay, so anyways, what is the answer is coming as, so let me check, it is 78. Okay, the answer is 78. With the help of calculator you can just find it out. It is 78. Okay, so this is this question, I felt it is an interesting question. I took this question from book, Aris Agarwal book. This question, I think this kind of question was asked, but anyways, it's better to do all kind of questions. Let me take another example and let's call it a day, and we can do other questions, okay, like other topics. So I, because this video, the half portion, at least the first two questions I shot 3 days back, and I didn't shoot any videos in last 3 days. So I thought of doing the average, continuing the average first, and then we will move on to set theory and algebra. Okay, so keep watching. So now let's take one last example and then we will move on to other topic. Okay, so now the average weight of A, B and C is 45. So A, B, C, so total weight will be 45 into 3. Okay, so now if the average weight of A and B is 40, so A and B is 40, so its total will be this. Okay, so and that of B and C is 43. B and C is 43, so the summation will be 43 into 2. Find the weight of B. So we have to find the weight of B here. So here you can see, we can write it like this. Okay, so A B can be A plus B plus B plus C. Okay, this two minus A plus B plus C. So you can see that, then we can come down to us, A and A equal cancelled out, then C and C will cancel out, B plus B is 2B minus B, that will come down to us B. So we can put the values here, A plus B is 40 into 2 plus B plus C is 43 into 2 minus A plus B plus C is 45 into 3. So answer B is, weight of B is coming down to us 31 kgs. Okay, I hope you have practiced with me. So 31 kgs. I hope you have practiced with me. So keep practicing. I'll keep adding videos. So I hope you have watched it. And if you loved watching my videos, please do like my channel and subscribe to like the video and subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon. Okay. So I'm trying to make videos now. So for 3 days I didn't. So I will make videos. I hope I can make later also, because this is what I love. Okay. So see you in next video. Okay, so bye, and I will try to upload it now because we have to merge and everything, because half portion was done before and now. So see you in next video.